your wound is probably not your fault, but your healing is your responsibility. And that is the thought for today. Welcome to 7 Good Minutes. I'm Clyde Lee Dennis. Thanks for joining me for what I believe will be 7 of the most enriching minutes of your day. In today's audio, we listen in as Dr. Wayne Dyer talks about how to notice signs the universe is testing you. Enjoy.
One of the most powerful lessons that you can ever learn, I had to learn as a young man. My own father was a man who walked away. He left. He left home when I was just a baby. Left my mother, who's sitting right here. 107 years old. Is that what you know? You're not 107. 82 years old, though. And with 3 little boys. And all I had ever heard when he walked out about this person that my older brothers told me about, and that when my mother got her family back together again when I was 9 years old, and did all that she could to make a family again with all the hardships. This was a man who never made a phone call, who never sent a penny, who spent some time in prison, who was an alcoholic, who died of cirrhosis of the liver at the age of 49 and was buried in a pauper's grave in Biloxi, Mississippi. And it wasn't until I went to his grave and was able to stand there. And I used to dream about this man and have this enormous hatred for this person whom I had never seen, just based upon what he had done to my own mother and to my brothers and so on, and all of the stories that I had heard and all the research that I had done. And I ended up at his grave 10 years after he had died, when I finally found out that he was dead. It was on the 27th of August. It was 1974. And what I did transformed my life. What I did is, I believe I was sent there by God, or whatever you want to call that divine spirit, the divine presence. And my life at that time wasn't working. I was overweight. My relationships weren't working. My writing wasn't working. There were a lot of things that weren't going well for me in my life at that time. Not badly, but they weren't going at the level that I knew I was capable of getting to, because I was filled with this hatred, this anger, this bitterness. And so what I did is, I stood there on his grave, on this little marker in the ground, and I said, "From now on, I send you love. I forgive you." Mark Twain said that forgiveness is the fragrance that the violet sheds on the heel that has crushed it. And once I let go of that anger and that hatred and all of my attachment to the bonding that I had done with these wounds, and let go of that and cleared that out of my life, my writing began to take place at a much higher level. In fact, I wrote Erroneous Zones in a very, very short time after that. I began to get myself back in shape. I began to eat better. I began exercising, got my weight down. And the people that were supposed to come into my life, like my beautiful wife, who sits here with me this evening, and all of our children, some of whom are here this evening, all of it was allowed to flow when I released that energy of negativity and blame and hatred. They say that you never die from a snake bite. It isn't the bite. And you can't be unbitten. It's in the wake. What kills you is the venom that continues to pour through you long after the bite has taken place. And that's something we have control over and we can change. And I'd like to suggest that what happens is that many of us bond ourselves to these wounds of our past. If I were to cut my hand, just cut it and watch it, my nature says, close up the wound. And I just have to watch it. And there's no doctor out there, there's no medicine out there that's going to heal that wound. There's something, there's a healing stream that I am connected to that will allow that wound to heal. So my nature says, close up the wounds. Don't bond to them. Don't hang on to them. Close them up. But supposing I say to myself, oh, no, you don't. There's no way I'm going to let you close up. You see, if I can keep you open And I can go to you and say, look at this. Say, what happened? Well, look at this cut I've got. Oh, you poor thing. Look at that. It seems to be getting worse. It's getting infected. Isn't that terrible? And if you practice this kind of a mentality, when your nature says close up the wound, but you keep it open, before long you lose your hand. And after that, you'll lose your arm. And the whole organism will be destroyed if you don't let your nature take over. And your nature also says, close up the wounds of your past. Close them up. And oftentimes we ignore our nature. I had a great teacher that came into my life through his writing. His name was Nisargadatta Maharaj. Lived in India up until the mid-1980s. And he wrote something called I Am That, which was very powerful and influential in my life. And one of the things that he talked about when he was asked the question, what's the difference between, say, a saint or a highly functioning human being, a spiritual master, a spiritual teacher, and the rest of us, is that they have unconditional love in them and you don't or we don't? And he said, no. He said, saints have unconditional love in them, and so do you. He said, the difference between ordinary human awareness and higher awareness people is that they have nothing else inside of them. That's all they have.
Please keep in mind, this is about half of the entire presentation. If you're up for a treat, you should definitely listen to the whole thing. You can do so by clicking the link labeled View the Full Video on YouTube in the show notes. So that does it for this episode of 7 Good Minutes. Until next time, let's be civil to one another out there. Thanks for listening.